water affects everything in the world around us. I've had these experiences where there's been too much water and also too little water, and often in the same place. I come from this city called Pune, which is in the western part of India, close to Mumbai. It's one of those weird places where you always have a water shortage in the summer. So we had these large containers at home and we used to collect water because we used to get water from the city only once a day or maybe once every other day. And then you used to have floods during the monsoon. So there was like a lot of work that had to be done in terms of water management. My name is Devashish Gokhale. I'm a third year PhD student in the Department of Chemical Engineering. I work with Professor Patrick Doyle in his group, and I clean water, specifically focusing on emerging contaminants and low concentration pollutants like heavy metals, so things like lead, for example. I think water is going to become a bigger and bigger problem, and as the population keeps growing, there's going to be a challenge associated with water supply, and there's going to be a challenge associated with water quality. As the quality of life of people around the world improves, you're making more and more molecules, and we're not sure what these do to the environment. I think these molecules are very insidious in that sense. So we keep eating them, we don't realize that we are eating them or drinking them. And then when you're 60, you get cancer or you have some kind of organ failure. And no one's really very sure about what their chemical properties are. So you can't really quickly tailor something to remove these specific molecules from the environment. So we make these materials called hydrogels, which are polymers containing a lot of water. And then we functionalize them by attaching various kinds of chemicals and modifying them in interesting ways. Of course, we want to do this in a very sustainable way. So the materials that we make are reusable. We can make them from plant-sourced materials. The polymers that I make look like a powder, so you could pack them into some kind of a filter, but you could also make a membrane or something. We get a bunch of contaminants, we dissolve them in the water so we know what's actually in there, and then we test to see whether we can actually remove those contaminants. And we've been very successful with that so far. But now I think we want to go into a real life setting. So we've been actually talking to the Cambridge Water Department and planning to get some water samples from the Charles River or one of the other reservoirs, and then testing our materials with these real water samples and then seeing how well we can do. And then also do this at various scales. So we've also had interest from several industries who require ultra pure water, like semiconductors, for example. Even as I think about what molecules I'm going to put into these materials, I think about where are these molecules going to come from, how much do these molecules cost. So if it's something which is expensive, then I'm not really going to spend a lot of time thinking about it in great detail, because I know how important it is to do something which is not just scientifically interesting, but something which is impactful in a real way. So I've always got that thought at the back of my head. Are people going to be able to afford this? Is it really going to reach the people who need it the most, who have to live with the dirtiest water that's out there? Constraining myself in the beginning, of course, makes it a tougher problem to solve, but then also you end up with a solution that's much more promising and could actually make a difference.